Hello everybody, welcome back to more Let's Play Pokemon Emerald. My name is Impolo18, and today we're not gonna fuck around because there's a few things that I needed to do, but my first recording actually got shot because my computer decided to overheat and just like lost everything. So I'm actually gonna try to navigate this. Oh, nope, two trainers. Oh no, just one? Okay. Anyway, I was going to try to navigate this so I could just get right to the gym leader, but I guess one battle's not too bad. So let's go ahead and use Peck. Yeah, I don't have the battle annotations on. I'll turn them on when I get to the gym leader, but for now, I don't really care if they're on or not. Huzzah! So, Kapusta! Super effective. So, hopefully this recording doesn't blow my computer to shits and giggles. But I actually did get a headset donated to me, by someone named Secret Fiery, or Fear, I don't know. Anyway, this is the gym leader, so I'm gonna go ahead and, let's see, on, shift, and, yeah, okay. So anyway, so she, sent me a headset, not teleport, she sent me a headset, after I've been waiting forever. Two people were gonna send me a headset, and neither of them managed to get it to me. The first person just altogether didn't send it to me, and the other person tried to send it, but I got sent back. So I don't remember your name, but if you still have that headset, feel free to keep it. So, because this one seems to be working pretty well. So, I'm still recording the same way I was last time with, you know, not wearing my headset. It's just playing the sound, and the microphone is picking up both. But I actually kind of prefer it this way, because that way I don't have it on my ears, and I'm not like screaming into the microphone because I can't hear myself talk. Because this headset and my last one had like those noise canceling headphones, and so like I just hear the music and I don't hear myself, and I feel that I can balance my commentary better if I can hear myself talking. Anyway, so on to the game. This is Brawling. Second gym leader uses fighting types. First off, you had a Machop, as you saw. I went ahead with Routes since Machop is a pure fighting type. So Confusion did pretty heavy damage. Now we're going to go ahead into Metatite, Psychic and Fighting type. I don't know why, but... Ooh. Brawly's strategy here is pretty much just going to try to get off a Focus Punch. Pretty much what happens is if you can hit it while it's tightening its focus, that's like the first stage of it. It's kind of like those other two stage attacks like Skull Bash and Sky Attack. But if it hits you, it does some pretty hefty damage, so, especially on Metatite, I would advise not using an auxiliary move. Just go ahead and keep hitting it and you'll win, as you saw. Anyway, last has got Maguhita. Now, Maguhita is pretty strong. It's got a pretty high attack and pretty good regular defense, but not the best special defense. Brawly's gonna go ahead with this move. It's called Bulk Up. Raises attack and defense one stat. I think his strategy here is pretty good. I mean, get some stats going, have a Citrus Berry to heal. But since he's raising defense, that's not going to really do anything for using Confusion, so I'm going to go ahead and just keep wailing him. I'm thinking right now, I mean, it's AI, but I'm assuming that, you know, the AI thinks it can get its stats up pretty high and not take too much damage. But like I said, Bulk Up would normally be pretty good, but with a special attacker, it's just fine. Even if you're not using a super effective move, special attacker is still gonna pretty much own in this gym. So one thing too I could mention is that if you have a Tallow, Tallow has actually worked pretty good here too. Especially with the type matching, they don't really have a problem against Metatite since there's no resistance for because of the psychic type. So I was checking my little box on the cord here, make sure my mic was on, so it's picking me up. Anyway, so we got Bulk Up, which is TM. I'm probably not going to teach it to anybody yet. I'm pretty sparse about TMs, but I'll go ahead and show it to you. There we go. So Bulk Up, first one, fighting, bulks up by boost, and you can just click on it like you were going to use it, and it shows you like the power, accuracy, and stat. I also got Rock Tomb from Roxanne, in case you guys forgot, and Steel Wing, which is a pretty beast attack. I got that from Steven for delivering the letter. Now, normally I would go and fight all these trainers in here for the experience, but because I really want to get this going again and get a lot of progress done, I'm going to go ahead and not do that. There'll be plenty of trainers I can fight off camera. That is actually one new thing I'm going to go ahead and do in this this one, as well as you've seen in my Soul Silver. In Soul Silver, I don't mind fast-forwarding them, but for this game, because it's got my commentary over it in the same stream, I'm actually not going to fast-forward. I'm just going to leave the battles in if I do have to fight a trainer. Otherwise, like, I'll just show you guys all the trainers that you can fight. Yeah, I know. No, I don't want to sail. Okay. So anyway, you can, these two trainers, those aren't trainers. This sailor here is a trainer. If you can see under this umbrella, there's a little pink thing moving. That's a trainer. That's a tuber. This yellow tuber, that sailor on the right, is a trainer. And then over here, right next to this Pokeball, one spot down where this potion is, under these two red umbrellas, there are two tubers there. If you look close, you can see them. Moving on the screen. But before we head right into SlatePort, you want to stop into this shop here. Talk to this guy, owner of the Sea House. He likes to see hot Pokemon battles, so pretty much what you gotta do, you just gotta fight all three trainers in here. So there's two trainers there, and then you can see there's a trainer down there. I'm gonna go ahead and fight the trainers real quick, and then I'll meet you guys right back here. Alright, so we're right back. I just, you know, quick fade. So I've defeated all the trainers, scorching hot battles, blaze, satisfied. Show me hot streak on it. Should I have these? A half dozen bottles of soda pop. Yeah, soda pop. It's like redundancy all over. So, and soda pop is actually pretty cool. I'll go ahead and show you guys. Let's see. Blah, there we go. So we got potion and we got soda pop. Fizzy drink restores 60 HP. I think if you buy them, they're actually like $600 or $700. So it's actually a pretty good deal. Anyway, so we got all these Team Aqua people here hanging out. And they're like, hey, quit pushing the line, can't you see? Anyway, so we can't do anything about that. I might go to the Pokemon Center and heal later. Anyway, so you want to come up here and talk to this lady. Thank you, friend. Oh, you're looking for a ship? Sorry, ferry service isn't available. Oh, crap. Oh, the guy tells me where Professor Stern is. Or Captain Stern. Oh, I totally am flubbing on this right now. Is going in there? No, that's not what does it. I think you have to go in here and talk to this guy up here. Let's see. Is there? This thing. Oh, dude. Yeah, I can't make a head test. Oh, hey. Oh, there. Devin Goodson. That is still on. Dude, somewhere off. He said he had work to do. Could you go find Gamster and deliver it to him? Alright, I think that is what triggers the people in the museum to leave. Oh, here we go. Yeah, here's Roxanne. Sorry I didn't mention this earlier, but because we fought Roxanne before we started taking numbers, she actually calls you, and she hears some brothers are moving up to the ranks of trainers at an incredible clip. All right, so anyway, she'll call you and give you her number, and then later on, you can actually go and have a rematch. Yeah, so we had to talk to that guy, and then that makes everybody here. I don't want to go to my trainer card. Derp. Anyway, so you go down here to match call, and one of the things in Emerald now is gym trainers will register themselves in your Pokenav, the Rockin' Wiz, Roxanne, and then the big hit Brawly. They will actually call you later on to ask for a rematch, so it's pretty cool. But we can see now all the Aqua people were in here. Welcome to the Oceanic Museum. The fee is 50. Sure. Do I have to pay for my plush bear too? Anyway, so don't even bother talking to any of these guys. I'm actually going to go ahead and switch out my Pokemon because Kumitor is going to be pretty much useless for these Aqua Trainers. And we come over here, and this is Captain Stern. Oh, yes, if you're looking for Stern, that would be me. Ah, those must be the parts I ordered Mr. Stone from Devon. Thank you, that's great. I can prepare for expedition now. And then these two butt wipes walk in. What are you, facade? Anyway, so they want to come to steal the Devon parts, but we're not going to let them. We're going to fight him. Round one. Fight! So, anyway, we got a couple of Team Aqua grunts. Now, they have Carvana. The reason I'm not using Routes is because Routes can only use Confusion, which is a Psychic-type move. And Carvana is a water and dark type. At least I'm pretty sure. It has the ability Rough Skin, which is kind of annoying, but Confusion is not going to do squat against this guy. So I just pretty much ignore it and just go ahead and use Peck. And like I said, Rough Skin's going to hit you, but that's really not a huge deal. I mean, early game, maybe, but not so much in late game. I think it's based off, I think it's like a certain percentage of how much damage you did to your opponent. Anyway, so, oh man, what a zest. The boss is going to be furious. Sniveling wimp. Let me take care of him. Round two. Fight! So I just go ahead and go with Combusken. Sent out Zubat. Oh yeah, Zubat. Kaboosted. Now here I actually could have used Routes, but I figure what else. Routes is gonna get Kumatora is gonna get experience later on anyway. So I'm just gonna go ahead and bump up Combusken to level 20 as fast as I can, just because I can. Alright, yeah, so they had a Carvana anyway, so it wouldn't have mattered. I would have had to switch out. So let's go, and I can actually double kick. Yeah, there we go. Okay, yeah, so you can double kick and just get him out in one shot. I totally forgot about that. I don't even know why that slipped my mind. So yeah, just go ahead. If you have a Combusken, go ahead and double kick. If you have a Mudkip, you should probably have a Marsh Taunt by now. Just ground attack would work fine. If you have a Trico, you should probably have a Groville by now, and just Leaf Blade will work wonders. Anyway, so we get Archie. Anyway, he's coming in to, you know, talk with us and talking about Team Magma and, you know, trying to go off and rant about how awesome the sea is and interfering with plans, and we just don't understand. Anyway, so he says, thanks for saying this. Oh, I forgot to give you the... Okay, so he hands us back the... Or we hand him over the Devon goods. So. But he's gotta go. And he goes ahead and spams elixirs and whatever on our Pokemon to get us all healed up. So, not bag. There we go. So you can see we're all healed up now. I'm gonna go ahead and put Kumatora back up front, just because I can. I'm gonna talk to this guy. What are you doing here? Oh, me, I'm going to hang my rumor to the rest of the tunnel. Anyway, this is the guy we whooped his ass earlier in the tunnel to save Pico. He's pretty sorry, so he's going to go ahead and give us this TM. I think it's Thief, if I'm not mistaken. Go ahead and... Yeah, it's Thief. So, 40 power, may steal an item. So, if your opponent has a hold item, you have a chance of, you know, retrieving it. Anyway, and then this guy's going to show up. His name is Scott. Huh? Oh, I'm sure you met you somewhere before. I've introduced myself to you. My name is Scott. I just saw Team Aqua run away from here, but they were stunned. And yes, I do know my voice sounds like the anime. Maybe just this trainer. Alright, I think I'm gonna be good for him. Let's register each other in our own Pokemon's. And register Scott in the Pokemon. I hope that voice picked up on the mic, because I did. It was kind of quiet, so I don't know. But yeah, I'm still working the kinks out, so let me know if the game sound is too high or my commentary is too loud. This over here is Battle Tent. It's a little something we'll get into later on, which really has no purpose. Name Raider's House, if you want to rename your Pokemon. I forget what this is. This is the Pokemon Fan Club. Okay, that's useless. Down here you can just buy some random crap that you really don't need, like house items and whatnot. Anyway, so that's pretty much it for SlatePort. The next area we gotta go to next is just up here. I think this is, yeah, Route 110. But I'm gonna go ahead and do that next time. So, cause I wanna keep these videos kinda short, cause I've been posting, like, longer videos lately. And I wanna keep these kinda short. So, I'll go ahead and meet you guys next time on Let's Play Pokemon Emerald. Spinning in a circle? I'm trying to spin in a circle, but it's harder on a D-pad. Or easier on a D-pad. Anyway, I gotta go. See you guys next time. Bye-bye.